Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Corporate Finance Online Classes. This is Dr. Mahesh M. Manjari, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. So it was a long break now in between for your remaining papers of semester one examination. So examinations are over, results are out. Okay, all the happy boys and girls are back here now. So let's get back to our basic duty of completing the syllabus of corporate finance, but not only completing syllabus, also putting effort to understand the subject, understand its implications, and wherever possible, you can apply the concepts as well. So one such platform provided to you is STMCET Stock Market Challenge 1. So now I'm going to share you, maybe the PowerPoint slide I'll share. Students, can you see the PowerPoint slides?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we were into Unit 5, Financing Decisions. So can anyone quickly recall what are those three decisions, okay, to be taken by a finance manager? Yeah, make it fast. This is the third decision. We already discussed about the first two decisions. What are the three major decisions a chief finance officer needs to take? Yeah, anyone, do not hesitate. Whatever the attendance, okay, you have come here to learn with your own interest. So do not hesitate to speak. Okay, so the three decisions that a CFO needs to take is one, investment decisions. Second is financing decisions, and third is a dividend decisions. So this is the second decision, financing decision. Okay, so it is about raising capital or arranging for finance for the purpose of investment. Okay, so in raising capital, as we come across some companies like Zomato is raising capital, LIC is also planning to sell some of its equity shares to general public. Okay, so this raising of capital, okay, can be done from different sources of finance, like equity by way of issue of equity shares, issuing preference shares, by way of issuing debentures, by way of borrowing loan from financial institutions. So when a company issues debentures, they are bound to pay interest on debentures to the debenture holders. When they borrow a loan from financial institutions, they are bound to pay interest on the loan borrowed as well as the repayment of the principal amount. So interest on debenture and interest on loans represent a fixed cost in the stream of finances of the company. So how these presence of fixed sources of finance like debenture capital or debt capital becomes a leverage, or company can use this source as a leverage to arrive at an optimum capital structure. What percentage of the total capital raise should be debt and what proportion of that should be equity? So in this regard, we have started learning the concept of leverages. I hope you can recall this image as well as the video which I shared from TED Ed. So I'm not going to explain again because sufficient time I had taken. I explained what is leverage. Then we learned about operating leverage as well as financial leverage. And in the end, yes, we learned about combined leverage or total risk of the firm. Okay, total risk of the firm or combined leverage is considered by an investor while planning to invest into the equity shares of a company. Okay, then this was the remaining, whatever we discussed among that, EBIT EPS analysis. So we have to begin from here. EBIT, can anybody recall what is the full form of EBIT?
Earnings before interest and tax.
Thank you. And EPS?
Earnings per share.
Earning per share.
Excellent. Okay. So There is one more way, okay, to arrive at the optimum capital structure. When I say capital structure here, what should be the proportion of debt and equity in the total capital is called as capital structure. So we have learned so far that the presence of sources of fixed cost, okay, of funds like debt capital, okay, can be used as a leverage to maximize earnings per share or to arrive at the optimum capital structure. So now we are going to learn how EBIT and EPS are related. So the EBIT EPS analysis is a method to study the effect of leverage, essentially involves the comparison of alternative methods of financing under various assumptions of EBIT. Okay, so this is a decision making situation. So you will get case studies related to EBIT EPS analysis. Say for example, you will have four different options in which a company can raise capital. For example, option one, a company is in need of 100 crore rupee capital. So they can decide to raise all 100 crore capital by way of issuing equity shares. Okay, this is method one or alternate one. Second option, all 100 crore rupee, okay, to be raised by term loan. Option three, 50%, 50 crore from issue of equity shares, another 50 crore from issue of debentures. Option four, 50 crore rupee from issue of equity capital, 25 crore rupee from issue of debentures, another 50 crore rupee from issue of equity shares, 25 crore rupee from issue of preference shares, another 25 crore rupee from issue of debentures. So among these four alternative methods of financing, okay, the finance manager should choose which alternative method of financing the required capital. So that can be determined by way of EBIT EPS analysis, and exactly that is what we are going to do. A firm has a choice to raise funds for financing its investment proposals from different sources in different proportions. I gave you four alternative options now. That is nothing but the different sources in different proportions. So this is referred to as a financing mix. For instance, the company can raise capital exclusively from equity, as I said, from 100 crore. Totally 100 crore can be raised by way of issue of equity shares exclusively, 100% by way of using debt, maybe debentures or term loan. Exclusively use preference share capital or use a combination of equity and debt in different proportions. Okay, so I mentioned a combination of debt, equity and preference capital in different proportions also it can use, or a combination of equity and preference capital in different proportions, and so on. There can be infinite number of methods in which a company can raise capital. So the choice of a financing mix would be one. So in what method among these six, let us consider the company should raise the required capital. So we call it the choice of financing mix. The choice of financing mix would be one which, given the level of EBIT, would ensure highest EPS. So what we are going to do in these cases, small cases, so we are going to find out, okay, at a given EBIT level, we are going to find out the earning per share in each type of financing mix or in each case of alternative method of financing. And wherever the earning per share is highest, we suggest the company to choose that method of financing or that alternative method of financing as it ensures highest earning per share. Can somebody recall why we should choose that alternative financing mix which ensures highest earning per share? Why the manager should choose such a financing mix? Yeah, anyone, make it quick. Hello. Yeah, anybody home?
Shareholder values.
Excellent, Keshav. Okay, the finance manager has to choose that alternative method of financing that ensures highest earning per share, because the objective or goal of financial management is to ensure shareholders' wealth maximization. And the only method to maximize shareholders' wealth is by ensuring highest earnings per share. Very good, Keshav. Thank you. So with that, now let me go ahead to the PDF file. Yeah, dear students, I hope you can recall. Okay, so we have already solved these illustrations or small problems. Okay, where we understood the concept of operating leverage. Okay, slowly you can recall all this. Then we also learned to calculate degree of operating leverage. Then financial leverage. Okay. Theory we learned through PowerPoint slides and numericals in PDF. Okay, so these are the financial leverage, and we also calculated degree of financial leverage, DFL. Okay, and then we arrived at combined leverage. I hope you can recall. You can obtain degree of combined leverage, or which is nothing but total risk of the firm, by simply multiplying degree of operating leverage by degree of financial leverage. Okay, so here in our cases, if the degree of operating leverage of a firm, okay, so I would like to remind you that degree of combined leverage measures the percentage change in earning per share due to the percentage change in sales of a company. Okay, so when you want or planning to invest in the equity shares of different companies, you can find out or consider the degree of combined leverage of that company. It represents the percentage change in earning per share due to the percentage change in sales. Okay, so the stock market challenge that you are playing, you are contesting, if you go there and add your stocks or different company stocks to watch list, okay, and you click on the company, it will give the historical data of that company's equity shares, as well as some financial data which you can use for the purpose of investment. Okay, so I don't know how many of you have used that feature in the stock market challenge watch list. So you can find out since last 10 years, okay, what has happened to the sales of the company. There will be a graph. You can find out whether the sales of the company are increasing, decreasing, or stable. Okay, so you can also find out the earning per share. So as a percentage change in sales, what has happened to the earning per share of that company? Based on that, you can decide to invest or not to invest in a particular company. See, that is why I told you, okay, whatever is being taught, okay, you are given an opportunity to apply that concept in real time, that too, and without a zero risk. Okay, only thing, you should be a little bit attentive towards the stock market challenge. Okay, so then, this is where we were. I have to begin from here, EBIT, EPS analysis. I explained the concept. Now I'll go ahead with the case number 7, or which is written as example in textbook. Okay, so a case study or case number 7 on EBIT, EPS analysis. So this is a detailed recap of what we have discussed so far in unit number 5, that is leverages. Anybody has any question, any query, any doubts, please raise now. This is the time. Yeah, pin drop silence again. Knock, knock. Anybody home? Hey, it is not only the responsibility of a class representatives. Okay, there are other students. I hope you have volunteered to attend the class. Okay, a kind yes or no would be kind for. Okay. Yeah. Any doubts? Any questions?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Thank you for your kind response. Please stay alert and awake, and please respond at least with a yes or no. Okay, so now case number 7. So we are going to consider, see here there will be a decision making situation, and you have to make a decision. And when you solve the problem at the end, you have to write your decision or recommendation. Okay, without which your answer will be incomplete. So suppose a firm has a capital structure. Capital structure means total capital and the proportion in which it has raised capital from different sources of finance, like debt, equity, preference, and so on. Suppose a firm has a capital structure exclusively comprising of ordinary shares. Ordinary shares means equity shares amounting to 10 lakh rupees. So this 10 lakh rupee total capital comprises of only equity shares. Okay, so 100% equity shares. The firm has wishes to raise additional capital of 10 lakh rupees for expansion purpose. Okay, so why any company raises additional capital? Maybe most of the times it is for the purpose of expansion or investment in new business. So the firm has a 4 alternative financial plans. The company can raise this additional 10 lakh rupee capital in any of the 4 through any of these 4 alternative plans. So the first alternative in which it can raise 10 lakh rupee additional capital is it can raise the entire amount in the form of equity capital, just like the previous case. Or it can raise 50% capital from equity and 50% from debentures. Okay, debentures carry 5% interest rate. Third alternative, it can raise the entire amount as 6% debentures, 100% debt capital. See, we are talking about only additional capital, huh? Remember this. Then, or it can raise 50% as equity capital and 50% as preference capital. Preference capital carry a coupon dividend rate of 5%. Okay, there is some additional information. Further assume that the existing EBIT, earnings before interest and taxes, is 1,20,000 rupees. So this given at the given EBIT level, we have to find out what will be the earning per share if the company raises capital from alternative plan 1, alternative plan 2, alternative plan 3, and alternative plan 4. And later we are going to suggest, okay, to raise additional 10 lakh rupees from any of these 1 alternative plans, in whose case the earning per share is going to be highest. They also provided tax rate is 35%. Outstanding ordinary shares. Okay, that is the number of equity shares in the company are 10,000 equity shares. And the market price per share is 100 rupees under all 4 alternatives. So the decision pending is which plan you should, the decision pending is which plan, which financial plan the firm should select. That is for you. Okay, as a student of finance, you need to find out the earning per share in each case and suggest that plan where the which ensures highest earning per share. Okay, so anybody who is not able to understand the case here, what is the case all about, or what is expected in the case, how to go about, that is what we are going to solve now, though I explained already what we are going to solve. So any questions here, anybody who is not able to understand? I will wait for your response. If you have any questions, doubts, please raise. Otherwise, if it's online class, you should say no otherwise. Huh?
No, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Dinesh. Thank you for the response. Now let's move ahead. Okay, so you need to prepare a table of EPS under various financial plans. So title of the table will be EPS under various financial plans. The financial plans are nothing but these A, B, C, D, the methods in which the company can raise additional capital. Okay. So now pay attention. So in this column, we are going to write about the particulars. And these are the 4 financial plans, A, B, C, and D. And what are we going to find out? EPS, okay, or earning per share under each case. Okay, so that's it. And whatever, whichever plan ensures highest EPS, we are going to suggest that plan to the company. So let's see how it is done. So it is simple, so please pay attention. because still you have I2 and I3. So these problems will come in, and this will come in I3. So first, the given level of EBIT is same. So as you can see from this case, EBIT, assume that the existing EBIT is 120,000 rupees under all four cases. So we are going to write that EBIT in each plan, under each plan, is 120,000 rupees. So assuming that the EBIT under all four plans is same, we are asked to choose the best financial plan through which the company should raise additional capital. So definitely, so since it is earnings before interest and taxes, you need to deduct interest. So where interest comes into picture, where there are fixed cost sources of finance like a debt capital or preference capital. So alternative plan A, if we consider the entire, it is suggesting to raise entire additional capital through equity shares. So there is no case of interest in alternate plan A. Alternate plan B, 50% capital through equity and another 50% capital through 5% debentures. Okay. So 50% capital, 50% of 10 lakh rupees is how much? 50% of 10 lakh. Yeah. 50% of 10 lakh is?
5 lakhs.
Yes. So the company has to pay 5% interest on this 5 lakh rupees. So what is the 5% of 5 lakh rupees?
5,000.
25,000 it is.
25,000.
Yeah. So in alternate plan B, since the 50%, 5 lakh rupee will be raised through issue of debentures, and debentures carry a 5% rate of interest. So 5% of 5 lakh rupee is 25,000, which we need to deduct. Then plan C. Plan C says it can raise the entire amount as 6% debentures. Okay. So debenture rate is already given 5%. Okay. So entire capital means 10 lakh rupees. Okay. So 6% of 10 lakh rupees is how much? 6% of 10 lakh. Yeah, 6% of 10 lakh is 60,000 rupee interest in case of, okay, alternate financial plan C. Financial plan D, 50% equity and 50% preference. So there is no interest. Okay, so once we deduct interest, so that is from plan, in case of plan B and in case of plan C. And what we get is earnings before taxes. EBT, earnings before taxes in case of plan A are 120,000. Here in case of B, 120,000 minus 25,000 rupees is equal to 95,000. Financial plan C, 120,000 minus 60,000 is equal to 60,000. And in financial plan D, it is 120,000. So these are earnings before taxes. So as the okay, sequence suggests, next go ahead and deduct taxes. Okay, so the tax rate is provided at 35%. Okay, so these are the taxable income in each case or each alternative. So 35% of that we have to calculate and write here. So less taxes. 35% of 120,000 is 42,000. 35% of 95,000 is 33,250. And 35% of 60,000 is 21,000. And 35% of 120,000 is 42,000. So after deducting, what we get is earnings after taxes. Okay, that is EAT, we also call it. So 120,000 minus 42,000 is 78,000. 95,000 minus 33,250 is 61,750. 60,000 minus 21,000 is equal to 39,000. 120,000 minus 42,000 is equal to 78,000 is the earnings after taxes in each of the four alternative financial plans. Once the taxes are paid, okay, see, do not forget, many students make this mistake, they forget to deduct preference dividend. preference dividend is paid first before the dividend is paid to equity shareholder. So after paying preference dividend, the remaining amount equity shareholders are paid equity dividend. So please remember. So preference capital exists only in case of a financial plan D. That is, it can raise 50% as equity capital and 50% as 5% preference capital. The coupon rate of dividend on preference shares is 5%. Okay. So 50% of capital means 5 lakh rupees. So 5% of 5 lakh rupees is a preference dividend. So 5% of 5 lakh rupees, 25,000 rupees will have to be paid as a dividend to preference shareholders. That exists only in case of a financial plan D. Okay, so when we deduct that, 78,000 minus 25,000, okay, what we get is earnings available to equity shareholders, which are under financial plan A, 78,000 rupees, under financial plan B, 61,750 rupees, under financial plan C, 39,000 rupees, and under financial plan D, 53,000 rupees. Okay. So this is earnings available to equity shareholders. Now, okay, so this earnings available to equity shareholder, we are going to divide it by the number of equity shares to obtain earnings per share, because we need to find out that financial plan which ensures highest earning per share. We have to suggest that. So now where this come from? 20,000, 15,000, 10,000 or 10,000, 15,000 are number of equity shares in each case. So I'll tell you, in financial plan A, see what happens. The first we need to remember that ordinary shares, okay. The firm has a capital structure exclusively comprising of ordinary shares amounting to 10 lakh rupees. So we should know that. So the first capital comprises only of equity shares. So the outstanding equity shares are given here already 10,000. So the company already has 10,000 equity shares. Okay, so they are planning to raise additional 10 lakh rupees for expansion. Okay, so they have also given the market price per share of the equity shares. Okay, so how I'm going to find out? So when I'm going to find out the total number of equity shares in financial plan A, first 10,000 equity shares already exist. 10,000 equity share already exists. Okay, so 10,000 plus. Now under financial plan A, the company is planning to raise another 10 lakh capital entirely in the form of equity capital. Entirely in the form of equity capital. Okay, and the information given is market price per share is 100 rupees. So how can we find out the number of equity shares in additional capital? Yes, anybody?
10 lakh divided by 100.
Excellent, excellent, Anushree. Okay, so 10 lakh rupees the additional capital required and the market price is 100 rupees per share. So 10 lakh divided by 100 will give you the number of equity shares additionally the company is going to issue. So 10 lakh divided by 100 is, if you remove two zeros, it will be 10,000 additional equity shares. The company already had 10,000 equity shares. Another 10,000 equity shares will be new. So 10,000 plus 10,000, total number of equity shares in the financial plan A are 20,000 equity shares. Now same way, remember this, the company already has 10,000 equity shares. So in financial plan B, okay, the company is going to raise 50% capital through issue of equity shares. So that is a 5 lakh rupees. That is a 5 lakh rupees. So same way how Anushree mentioned, 5 lakh divided by 100. 5 lakh divided by 100. What is the answer?
5,000.
5,000, yes. 10,000 old shares plus 5,000 new shares. So in case of financial plan B, the total number of equity shares will be 15,000. Financial plan C, there is no issue of equity shares here. So only the old equity shares remain. Okay, so 10,000 old equity shares we are going to write as it is. And in case of financial plan D, what happens? The company is planning to raise 50% of the additional capital by way of equity capital. So that we already considered in case of financial plan B. So 5 lakh rupee divided by 100 rupees. So 5,000 new equity shares. So 10,000 old equity shares plus 5,000 new equity shares is equal to 15,000 equity shares. So I have not given working note for this. Okay, as these are from 6th, 7th standard class, okay, calculations. But I did explain in detail orally with the help of the data given. So now what are we going to do? Divide the earning available to equity shareholders by the total number of equity shares to arrive at the earning per share. It is simple. That's why you need to have calculator. So 78,000 divided by 20,000 equity shares is equal to 3.9 in the earning per share under financial plan A. So 61,750 minus 15,000 is, okay, sorry, 61,750 divided by 15,000 equity shares is equal to 4.1 in the earning per share under financial plan B. So 39,000 rupees divided by 10,000 equity shares is equal to 3.9 is the earning per share in case of financial plan C. 53,000 divided by 15,000 equity shares is equal to 3.5 is the earning per share in case of financial plan D. Okay, so that's how we analyze the EBIT EPS. So yeah, though it is visible, but can you somebody reply quickly? So under which financial plan or which financial plan ensures highest earning per share to the company?
B, sir.
Yeah, under financial plan B. Now, what does that mean? Please try to understand. It means the company, since the company is planning to raise an additional capital of 10 lakh rupees, the company suggested to raise this additional 10 lakh rupee capital by way of 50% as equity capital and 50% as debenture capital. Okay, so that is the decision. So the firm should select financing plan B. It means the company should raise additional 10 lakh rupees under financial plan B. Okay, so that's all about this. So any questions? Any questions from your end?
No, sir.
Okay, so that's great. Okay, so we have still slightly over a minute, so I cannot end the meeting. Okay, so I have to wait till the meeting gets over. Then I will restart the meeting and you have to join back. When first I'll take attendance. And there are small couple of announcements related to CTA 2, Stock Market Challenge, SDMCT Stock Market Challenge 1, and about internship as well. In the meanwhile, if anybody has anything to say or share anything, you can do it. We have 60 seconds. Okay, then